And his girlfriend comes, you know, tromping down the stairs, and she goes, "So are you gonna marry me or what?"
Got a crazy video for you today.
She's not yours, it's just your turn. A woman should be a compliment to your life, not the focus.
Do the work.
Women do not care about your struggles, they hang out at the finish line and they pick the winners. What's up, my brothers? It's one of those times of years where I've always got a friend that pings me up and says, "I got the crap or get off the pot call conversation." So I want to have a chat about that and baby rabies and all the sorts of dynamics that tie into that and why it happens. A lot of guys will succumb to this. Let me share a quick story with you. A good friend of mine, he was around his early 30s, 33, 34. His girlfriend was about 3 years younger than him at the time. And she was talking about babies and marriage and kids and all that sort of stuff. And he wasn't quite ready for it. He was interested in it. It was an idea that he had rolling around his head, but he wasn't ready to rush into anything just yet. And there was a couple of red flags that she was throwing up as well, right? So the way he broke down the story for me is, dude is sitting there, it's around Christmas time, and he bought this beautiful train set, like the Santa Claus train set, put it all around the tree and the presents and all that sort of stuff, and he's looking at it, getting it set up, and his girlfriend comes, you know, tromping down the stairs, and she goes, "So are you gonna marry me or what?" Like, one of those kind of like attitude-filled sort of conversations. And from that point on, he wasn't really sure what to do, but, you know, he went for it. He did the right thing. He manned up. You know, he got the ring, put out something like 1.8 carats on her finger, spent over, I think, 10 or 11 grand on a piece of dinosaur poo that had been sitting in the ground forever. That doesn't really have much use either. I should do a separate video on stones versus dowries. I think that's an interesting dynamic too. But anyway, it didn't work out for him. Dude was divorced within about 3.5 years and went through a brutal custody battle, had all kinds of problems with money and all kinds of things that tied into the dynamics of the things that happen to men in family law. So I think when it comes to the shit or get off the pot conversation, you guys need to slow it down a little bit and take a little bit of time to reflect on what's good for you. We talk about mental point of origin often. Happens all around with guys in this space trying to help men become better versions of themselves. And realistically, at the end of the day, if you're going to make yourself your own mental point of origin, you want to become the best version of yourself, you need to make sure that with every decision, you do make yourself your own mental point of origin. A lot of guys don't seem to understand or get it through their thick skulls that a wedding, a marriage, is a massive legal obligation. In fact, I'm going to say it this way. Setting aside something like death in a will, it is probably the biggest decision you're ever going to make in your entire life. And most guys just blindly or just sleepwalk into it. They don't put a lot of thought into it. They'll spend more time with their fiancés trying to figure out whether they're going to put pink doilies or green doilies on their invitation for the wedding than the dude will actually spend deciding if this is the right person that he's going to put a ring on and enter into a marriage contract that allows the state to decide what happens to access to his kids or his wealth if things should not go well. So, back to the crap or get off the pot conversation. My advice to you guys is get off the pot. If you're not ready, if you're not fully sold on the idea of marriage or kids, and you don't have an intense burning desire for it or for her in particular, or there's red flags that go up, baby rabies is one of them, by the way. Let's just kind of marinate on that for a little bit. If you haven't downloaded the free chapter on the red flags for my upcoming book, in the pin top description, or I'll put a card up in the top right so that makes it easier for guys on mobile, grab it. Baby rabies is a big one. I got divorced around 38, 39, I think it was, so a number of years ago. And one of the things that I noticed when I was re-entered onto the sexual marketplace was the amount of women that were, well, almost all of them were divorced and with child in tow when you date around that age. So the thing that you got to get your head around is when you start having these conversations with these women, I always used to like, because I was interested. I was like, you know, so why'd your marriage end, right? I mean, I knew what mine ended, but I was always interested. So why did your marriage end? And there was a consistent pattern of baby rabies that showed up in a lot of these women's conversations when they would download this story to me. And it was some version or some effective story that relied on, well, I was blah, 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 basically insert on the carousel up until about 28, 29, 30.
at which point she hit the epiphany phase and decided, okay, I'm done with the bad boys. They're not going to wife me up. They just want to use me for sex or something along that line. And they were looking for a guy that was just good enough. And that's not a term that you hear that much in guys that broadcast in this space. You know, they'll use the beta provider as a placeholder. But the just good enough to them was, well, he's got decent genes. He's tall enough. He seems funny enough. I think he'd make a good dad. He's got a decent enough job that he can pay the bills and a mortgage sort of thing. And that was their good enough narrative. And they didn't tell me that they gave him the shit or get off the pot lyric, but what they did was they basically said some lyric along the lines of, I just told him that it was now or never sort of thing. Like, women start to feel baby rabies, not always in their 30s, sometimes it's earlier. I've heard women, you know, women as young as 26, 27 express it, but definitely into the 30s, you're going to find a lot of childless women that are looking for the dutiful beta. A lot of them go on dating sites and online sites and the swiping apps and all that sort of stuff. And they've got some lyric or some narrative about, you know, done with the bad boys, looking for a good, responsible guy to start a family with. And then they, at some point in the dating process, will give them the crap or get off the pot story. And guys, I'll tell you this right now. If you don't know her for at least a couple of years, shout out to Dr. Shanti Smith with The Tactile Guide to Women. Big, big takeaway from that book, gentlemen, is spend at least 2 years getting to know what you're dealing with. Introduce stress into the relationship. Travel, let the baggage get lost. Go to a country where they don't speak your language. Introduce stress to the relationship and see what happens. If that's on the agenda for you, I'm vehemently opposed to marriage. I've already said that a number of times, so that should not be new to you. But if you're going to walk into the slaughterhouse, at least do it with your eyes wide open so you know what you're getting into and you properly vetted them. And if she's trying to rush you into it, meaning let's just get this done, come on buddy, we got a shit or get off the pot, we're running out of time, eggs are drying up every single month, you start hearing that, or you start to feel that sort of narrative, and you start to feel like you're just going to be an accessory to her life. She's not going to complement your life. She's going to be the focus of it, and her agenda will be the focus of it, and everything she wants to do is going to be the focus of it. Just get off the pot and walk away. Take some time. You need at least a couple years to see what she's all about. And if she, whatever reason, waited till her late 30s, you know, her inability to prepare for it does not constitute an emergency on your end. You've probably heard some version of this, or don't make your problems my problems. You don't know her for a good period of time. She's expressing red flags to you, and now she's giving you the deadline of crap or get off the pot because she's going to go find another guy if you're not willing to put a ring on it or whatever. Just get off the pot and walk away. You need to take your time to it and make sure that you've at least got full disclosure and understanding on what you're walking into. Because in the Western world anyway, I mean in North America, whether you're in Canada, the States, I don't care, even many places in Europe, it's pretty much the same. Family laws hostile towards men. Women always reserve the right to change their mind at any given time. In fact, most of them do when it comes to divorce. I've coached many, many guys going through the divorce machine that thought that they wifed up a beautiful, conservative, you know, church-going woman from a great family that's unbroken, blah, 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 like insert their narrative. And then at some point, you know, 7.1 years later when they get divorced and they're going through the machine, she's all of a sudden become a liberal feminist and, you know, grinding his gears. So take your time, gents. It is one of the biggest decisions that men will make in their lifetime. It is the biggest decision that you will ever make in your entire lifetime. I'm going to stress that. So take your time. Slow down, turn off the afterburners. You're the guy that decides when this happens, not her, okay? You've probably heard some lyric along the lines of women are the gatekeepers to sex and men are the gatekeepers to relationships. You gentlemen that are watching this are the gatekeepers to marriage if you so choose to walk into that slaughterhouse. Make sure you do it with your eyes wide open so you know exactly what you're getting into and you have a good understanding of what she's all about. If there's any red flags, identify them early on. If there's several red flags, my recommendation is walk away. There's 20 in that chapter that I've linked in the description below, so grab that. I'm gonna leave it at that on that video, guys. I know that some of you are kind of past this point, and you've been through the divorce machine and you probably saw this coming, or you got the, you know, shit or get off the pot narrative, guys, leave a comment below. Let guys out there understand what it's really like and what you went through so that they can hear it from more than one person. And for those of you that are younger, maybe coming up to this point or at this point right now where they've been lectured on the, so are you going to marry me or what? Don't rush into anything, guys. It is the biggest decision you're going to make in your entire life. Give it at least a couple years if you're going to walk into that slaughterhouse. Do it with your eyes wide open and make sure there's no red flags. Out of that chapter of 20, in my estimation, those are the ones that you should look out for the most. I've done a couple of videos highlighting a few of them, but go through it. The book's going to be available in a few months. Grab that chapter. It's free. All you got to do is opt in with your email address. I'm not going to spam you or send you any nonsense crap. If I send you anything, it's going to be relevant to that. So get on that list, grab that, check it out. Want to thank you for watching today's video. Give it a thumbs up and definitely leave a comment below. There's a few other informative pieces after this video. We'll see you guys later. Peace. All right, brothers, hope you enjoyed that video. Before you go, there's some important links that I want to go over with you. Just beneath the Teespring merch store over here, if you scroll down to the top comment, it's always pinned by me. You can expand by clicking the Read More button, and there's a bunch of useful links. I'm going to go over just the three main ones with you. The first one is, a lot of guys are often asking me about, how do I network with other red-pilled guys? How do I find other guys that I can help level up that are chasing excellence in life and not women and blah, blah, blah. Well, that's it. That's my men's community. So if you click through to that card up on the top right, you'll get over to entrepreneursandcars.com/community. There's a video there that explains exactly how it all works and what the perks are and a bunch of useful information beneath that. So check that out. The next link that I want to go over with you is my clarity.fm link. Again, that's also pinned in the top description where it says get one-on-one coaching with me. A lot of you guys send me messages. I'm stuck on this. How do I get out of this problem? I'm going through divorce. What's the solution? My business startup question is this. Well, there's a link over there. You click that, top right of the screen, hit it, and you're going to come through to this page where you can book me for a call. It's billed by the minute, so we can go as long or as short as you need to. Most people seem to book like a 15-minute call, and we'll go 15 to 30 minutes or so. But take a look at all the reviews. Most of the stuff that I help out with tends to revolve around either dating advice or surviving divorce. I also do entrepreneurship coaching as well, men's high-performance coach stuff, so check it out. Reviews are all 5-star. I've done a ton of these calls. We're getting close to 400 now, so consider that if you need help with something you're stuck on and you're serious about getting unstuck. The last one is the Grondike Soap Company, which, by the way, gentlemen, is a proud channel sponsor. Scott's been a great supporter of the creation of content on this channel. Most of you don't know this, but many of my videos get demonetized or only run limited ads, so Scott helps out a ton. You're showering anyway, so why not buy handmade soap from a sponsor that supports the creation of my content? When you check out with coupon code Cooper, you'll get 10% off. It is pheromone infused soap. You're gonna click this link over here and land on the Grondike page. And they've got some great value packs. Obviously, the more you buy, the deeper the discount. But when you check out, make sure you check out with coupon code Cooper and you'll get that discount at the checkout till. Again, thanks for watching the content today. Make sure you hit subscribe. We'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.